For the past 2 years, Adventures in Partnership Burger King has made it possible for children from all the elementary schools to attend a leadership seminar. And this year, we had 3 students who attended that seminar, and their responsibility after getting to do that is to come back and share what they learned at the seminar and tell us something about the speakers. And so we'll ask Rika Sukrum, Stetson Hayes, and Christy Jensen to come forward.
My name is Stetson Hayes. To my left is Christy Jensen. To her left is Rika Sukrum. We were selected to go to a Burgership Land seminar by our teachers. It was at UNL. We got into groups of 4, and there were 4 speakers. The speakers had a little introduction, and they could ask questions. We were selected because our teachers thought we had leadership potential.
We listened to 4 leaders speak: Karen Jennings, Jerry Strickland, Troy Branch, and Frank Hopkins. Karen Jennings, a UNL women's basketball player, told us how to be a good leader by setting good examples, studying hard, making goals for yourself, standing up for yourself, and being a leader and not a follower. Frank Hopkins, a warden at the state penitentiary, also told us that the qualities of being a leader are caring, dedication, education, enthusiasm, hard work, and being responsible.
We also heard from Jerry Strickland, who is a regional vice president at State Farm Insurance. He told us to try our best and make good judgments. He said that it is important to spend time with your family. Troy Branch, who is on the UNL football team, spoke to us too. He said that a leader leads by example and that you should do what you want to do and not what someone else wants you to do. We enjoyed this seminar because it has taught us the values of a leader.
Of seeing an alumni of Hill School return and accept a scholarship that is offered by the PTA. Mrs. Sue Wilkins is the president of the Ruth Hill PTA, and she will make that presentation at this time.
Like Ms. Sittler said, every year the PTA at Ruth Hill honors one of our outstanding alumni with a scholarship, and we are proud this year to award Lori McNeil with that scholarship. Come on up, Lori. Lori is a senior at Southeast and plans to go to UNL this fall in international studies. Is that right? She is a busy girl. Along with working 15 to 20 hours a week at Sears, she is president of DECA at Southeast, swims with Synchronize, is involved with volunteering at Lincoln General Hospital, busy with church activities and Young Life, and is still in the top 10% of her class at Southeast. So congratulations, Lori.
First of all, I'd like to thank Hill School PTA for making this scholarship possible and for the invitation to attend this program, which honors the 6th grade class tonight. Very briefly, I'd like to share with you a poem that I found last week as I was going through school papers. And I masterized this in my 6th grade class in language arts on May 13, 1985. Here's to you, dear old high school. I can't believe it's time to go. Goodbye to the teachers and my friends. Your help will always show. Here's to you, dear old high school, old Hill School. I think you are the best. All the teachers here are great and stand well above the rest. Here's to you, dear old high school, with plenty of hands to lend. I think this school is very cool. I can't believe it's now the end. This poem seemed to sum up all my feelings and about the experiences I had at Hill. And I know that many of you feel the same way that I do about Hill. It seems like yesterday when I was seated where you are tonight, just as scared and excited for junior high as you probably are right now. I have some final pieces of advice for all of you as you continue on to junior high. Study hard, try your best, don't give up if you fail at a task, and don't forget to always have fun. Thank you.
are ready now for those odes to Ruth Hill School. And there are a group of students that will come forward and we'll be ready to read those. So hang on to those, guys. You never know when you can come back and receive a scholarship and be able to read that. That was fun to hear yours again. The people that are going to read their odes are Seth Miranda, Colin Elder, Melissa Segura, Eric Schneeber, Jill Catalog, and Kyle Keller. Come forward.
Here's to you, dear Old Hill School. No one leaves here a fool. You've taught me to spell, and I've learned it well. You're a great learning tool. Here's to you, dear Old Hill School. You've never been a bore. I've learned all the math, taken the right path. Now I'll go out the door. Here's to you, dear Old Hill School. I've learned the golden rule. I'll never forget the people I've met. Thanks to you, Ruth Hill School. Here's to you, dear Old Hill School. You saw me through the good and through the bad. Now I will give this ode to you, Old School. Here's to you, dear Old Hill School, Ruth Hill, you really need. Times were funny, times were sad, Ruth Hill, you can't be beat. Here's to you, dear Old Hill School. I've learned a lot at Hill, like spelling words and reading books, and I thank you for it all.
Here's to you, dear Old Hill School. My years here were neat. I learned here the golden rule and how to make things complete. I will miss the science and math, also homeroom and reading too. But I will lead a different path. I learned here. I learned things here and how I grew. There are still memories here that I will never forget. Those memories I will keep near, but there are new ones yet.
Here's to you, dear Old Hill School. It is always nice here. You have made me full. You've always been near. Reading, spelling, science, and math. And don't forget Mrs. Vassa, Hirsch, and Ferguson. You have led me on the right path. Here it's always been real fun. Off to pound I go, it's the other place to be. My grades won't be so low because you have helped me.
Here's to you, Old Ruth Hill School. Even though I've only been here 3 years, you were a great learning tool, but I will still have many tears. I've learned a lot, and now that I have to go on, that I haven't forgot. I will still remember the Ruth Hill song. I will always remember what you gave to me. You made me ready for junior high. I was the door and you were the key. I will always try.
Here's to you, dear Old Ruth Hill School. I met a lot of friends. You are a great learning tool, so learning never ends. In PE, we run a lot. During lunch, we eat meat. In math, we learn to plot. Now I look back, going to Hill was a treat. When I came here, my knowledge was very small, and over the years,
thank you. That's a tough job when you have to stand up in front of this whole group. So they did a nice job. Our speaker this evening is Dr. Ruthann Linus. Ruthann was a former English consultant for the Lincoln Public Schools and retired. Will retire soon, and so we will wish her well as she moves on to some new things in her life. Ruthann, we're pleased to have you here to speak to this class.
What speakers do at times like this is to tell the story. They tell the story of what it is that unites all the folks in this room. That is, of course, sixth grade promotion. I'm pleased to be the storyteller. But you know, a story needs an author, and that's you, each of you, sixth graders. Let's imagine that everything that's happened to you at Hill is part of a story. It's a story that you have written and revised and edited and published. you will recognize the parts of the writing process. Tonight, I'll be talking to you about a new story that you can write. That story will need some characters. Well, that's you again, sixth graders, and your families, and your friends, and your teachers. The story needs a setting for its beginning. That's Hill on May 20th, 1991, after 7 in the evening. For the plot or the action, let's think about what will happen to you in the years to come after you leave Hill. The story also needs a theme or a big idea. And the theme of tonight's story that begins with this celebration of your promotion is time for a new beginning. Think about that. Time for a new beginning. The important thing about tonight is not so much that you're ending something, your years at Hill, but that you're beginning something, the next years of your lives. Miss Sittler and the Hill teachers say that this is a night for looking forward, not for looking backward. From Hill, you will always remember so many good things. The teachers, the things you've learned, the skills you have gained, the friendships you have made, your acquaintances, and your experiences. Whatever of those things is already in your own personal Hill story is certainly ready to be published. It's finished, it's not changeable. But you can now write a new story. One that might have the working title of middle level school or teenage years. And that story has some nice fresh blank pages. On them you can write anything you want to. Authors, you know, have a lot of power. They can create whole worlds and people and put them all into motion. You are the author as well as the principal character in the story of your next years. What do you think you're going to include in the plot to make those years all that they really can be? Ask yourself, how satisfied are you with yourself as a student? Do you want to be a better student? Do you want to take more advantage of all the wonderful learning opportunities in the Lincoln Public Schools? Do you want to get the best grades of which you are capable? Then do it. Students who are as good as they can be, you know, set aside time for study and they do their schoolwork before they go out to play or before they watch television rather than the other way around. They listen to their teachers and they ask questions when they don't understand or when they wonder, why do you suppose that is? They ask for help when they've gone as far as they can go all by themselves. You, much more than your family or your teachers, are responsible for you, the principal character in the story yet to be written. If you want to be a better student, be one. You're the author. How satisfied are you with your friends? Do you wish you had more of them? Or some perhaps who are more interested in what interests you? People who have friends are friendly. They know that each and every person brings something new to this world. Find out about other people. Go beyond the circle of your present friends. And you will find the friends that you need. Sometimes we take our families for granted, don't we? We perhaps spend less time being consciously nice to them than to people we only know slightly. As you make your new beginning, that the Hill teachers have said, will be the theme for tonight. It's a good time to look at how you get along with those who are very nearest and dearest to you. If you can think of some improvements, now is the time to put that into the story of your new beginning. And last, let's think about your accomplishments. Are you satisfied with all the skills you have? Life has so many opportunities. You can make a new beginning in learning a new skill. One that's all your own. Whether it's singing or dancing or drawing or acting or kite flying or whistling or running or piano playing or soccer or football or softball or tennis or pitching and catching. or sewing or carving, the list could go on and on. People who develop skills work at them. They devote time to them and they practice, practice, practice. You, your major character, can do the same. It's up to you. Make practice a part of your story, or more practice a part of your story for the next years. Have you ever, when you've read a story, just wanted to sit there for a while and think about it, turn it over in your mind before you move on to the next event? You're probably doing that tonight. Your years at Hill Elementary have given you some very good memories, certainly a lot of things that are worth thinking about before you go on. This is a very comfortable place to be. Laura Ingalls Wilder, the author of a story that you've probably read or have read to you, knew about that feeling. She wrote about it in the first pages of The Little House on the Prairie. Imagine that you sixth graders are very like Mary and Laura and baby Kerry in the story, and your families and teachers are like Ma and Pa. You'll remember that the family was leaving the little house in the Wisconsin woods for a new beginning on the Great American Prairie, where Pa said, and this sounded very nice to him, wild animals could live without being afraid. In Wisconsin, there were too many people for that to happen. Almost every day, a wagon brought some new settlers to the region. Pa said it was time to move on. And here's the part of the story that I think is a little bit like tonight. One day, in the very last of the winter, Pa said to Ma, "Seeing you don't object, I've decided to go see the West. I've had an offer for this place, and we can sell it now for as much as we're ever likely to get, enough to give us a start in a new country." "Oh, Charles, must we go now?" said Ma. The weather was so cold, and the snug house was so comfortable. "Well, if we're going this year, we must go now," said Pa. "We can't get across the Mississippi after the ice breaks." So Pa sold the little house. He sold the cow and calf. He made hickory bows and fastened them upright to the wagon box. Ma helped him stretch white canvas over them. In the thin dark before morning, Ma gently shook Mary and Laura till they got up. In firelight and candlelight, she washed and combed them and dressed them warmly. Over their long red flannel underwear, she put wool petticoats and wool dresses and long wool stockings. She put their coats on them and their rabbit skin hoods and their red yarn mittens. Everything from the little house was in the wagon, except the beds and tables and chairs. They did not need to take these because Pa could always make new ones. There was thin snow on the ground. The air was still and cold and dark. The bare trees stood up against the frosty stars, but in the east the sky was pale, and through the gray woods came lanterns with wagons and horses, bringing Grandpa and Grandma and aunts and uncles and cousins. Mary and Laura clung tight to their rag dolls and did not say anything. The cousins stood around and looked at them. Grandma and all the aunts hugged and kissed them and hugged and kissed them again, saying goodbye. Pa hung his gun to the wagon bows inside the canvas top where he could reach it quickly from the seat. He hung his bullet pouch and powder horn beneath it. He laid the fiddle box carefully between pillows where jolting would not hurt the fiddle. The uncles helped him hitch the horses to the wagon. All the cousins were told to kiss Mary and Laura, so they did. Pa picked up Mary and then Laura and set them on the bed in the back of the wagon. He helped Ma climb up to the wagon seat. Grandma reached up and gave her baby Kerry. Pa swung up and sat beside Ma, and Jack the brindle bulldog went under the wagon. So they all went away from the little house. The shutters were over the windows, so the house could not see them go. It stayed there inside the log fence behind the two big oak trees that in the summertime had made green roofs for Mary and Laura to play under, and that was the last of the little house. And that's the last part of the story that we'll be for tonight. Like the children in that family, you're surrounded tonight by your nearest and dearest. We all wish you well. Hill School sends you on your way with learning. It's like the warm red mittens, the bullet pouch, and the fiddle, and the story. And everything that Hill School is sending you forth with tonight will serve you well in the years ahead. Your own personal Hill story may be published, but the story of your new beginning, the one in the years to come, can be anything that you, the author, want it to be. And all of us here tonight wish you success with it.
Stephanie Down. Colin Elgert. Stephen Hayes. Michael Kinghorn. Bobby McCrary. Seth Miranda. Ben Mariofsky. Dave Morgenstern. Heather Morrow. Jackie Hawk. Trey Fitzgerald. Ryan Ragsdale. Chris Spiegel. Kerry Schill. Susan Sondeiger. Angie Stoles. Brett Stoles. Eric Slick.
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay.
I know what this is.
That's from Kerry and Jen.
Okay. Yeah, okay,
and
that's good.
What
black?
Is it?
Yeah,
black. I asked them if they'd give me 1 gram.
Well, what
black.
Is
they're,
it? They're for his Oakleys.
His
they're for my sunglasses.
Oh.
Good. This is something I wasn't didn't want to shell out the money for, but if you get it, it's good.
Well, you don't have to pay for it.
Yeah. Yeah,
well,
this
is
good.
Kind of a luxury.
Yeah, good, the yellow one. Don't care what they're wrong.
Oh.
What?
Is that a Barbie?
Yeah.
And this is for me.
Yeah,
like,
I like the wrapping paper for
your program. If you don't want it, I'll take
what
it.
What is it?
Oh, okay, this is good. This is good too.
What is that? Laser
yeah,
light.
To hold
this
CD.
24.
See, and all you have to do
but it has
this
that
is from just
Kerry.
Yeah, and all you have to do
this
is
this is like Dan's, right?
Yep.
Yeah, okay, good. That's good because mine get all scratched up.
You just push the button and the CD comes out.
How many is this one?
That's what it's supposed to be.
Not that much, but nice. I mean, it looks nice.
Oh, that's nice. You get all these CDs and all the tapes, and you don't know where the heck to put it all. And your video things.
It's so hot.
What class?
See, that's why I got
you. Spike it in your point.
I will.
No,
I will.
She did a good job in shaping it in the bathroom.
I'd probably go with the Jaguar.
Gosh, I knew it.
Pass those cards, I want to see what they
that's
say.
A good card.
Are you
like
Lincoln
it.
Like a car?
Yeah.
Rick, Laurie, Abby, Emily, Lacey, Baby, Luke, Bessie, and Larry.
Why did
Larry,
you
Larry,
your
that pretty much sums it up.
You could take all those birds and dogs and everything?
It's kind of more of that a father would give to. So.
It was.
What was it?
That card has a bad attitude.
Working at the credit bureau, I realized how things these things happen.
Yeah.
Did you put that in there?
Yeah, I did.
Mm-hmm. Well, it wasn't sure what we wanted to have in the check because our girl was going to be a good question. So
you graduate like gas? You passed.
We should read it out loud.
Yeah, let's read it out loud.
You graduate like gas. You passed.
That's a perfect card.
Yeah, I'll say.
Why do I keep eating this corn? I gotta stop.
This must be from mine at Sherna Alma.
You could be sure and read that one too, please. What?
Yeah, this is the best one yet.
Whoa, full moon.
This one.
Full moon.
21 buns. They're pretty cute. Thanks.
They were made for you, those cards, Susan.
Yeah. Yeah. The gas.
The bugs.
The car. The bugs.
I saw that. I saw that.
This must be for my mom.
Look at all the bugs.
Oh, I suppose he got a mushy one from his parents.
I mean, look at, and the pants is down here, you know.
It's warm in here.
You need a fan up here.
Chop your head off and stood up.
Yeah, really. Short ceiling in here.
Oh,
yeah. Thanks, everybody.
The floor's raised.
Now, who wants what kind of pie?
I want the.
Mom, this is overwhelmed with weeds here, but now that I'm not working, I should be able to handle getting the weeds out of here. Imagine the weeds not being there as you look into the beautiful summer colors. These are peonies, Mom. We were trying to remember what they were called. Looking through this camera, it looks like a bunch of weeds. Not sure what all this stuff is. This stuff's kind of dying out. And this stuff's hot and thirsty. Notice the birdhouse, full of martins.
Thank you.
showboat.
Joshua William Holmes, Greg Anthony Cox,